fish bones. Well, that structure is the first map around 1938. Here. What I'm going to be doing, we'll be walking into the parking lot. You see that truck right there, a small truck right there?
Right beside that structure, I'll be briefing you guys, giving you guys a brief history of this side here. After you finish on there, behind these pyramids, these temples right here, or these buildings, you know, is a ceremonial building, which I'll be giving you information. Walking on to the main building back there, the castle, or the El Castillo. Okay, and after we finish from El Castillo, we'll be coming right back down, or walk, or go to the balcony. Where somebody's gonna be sacrificed at the end of the day.
Okay.
Okay. So we just need to ask for a volunteer. And after we do the ball court, we're gonna be stopping at the building back there. You see the law building all the way back there. We'll be looking at original carved monuments. Oh. Original carved monuments. And after we finish from there, this is gonna be our last stop before lunch.
Okay.
This is what we're gonna be looking at, a scale model of this place, and also to look at some ancient pictures that were taken in the early 1950s, you know, to have a clear view of what this place was like when it was still virgin, comparing to what it is now, and to look at the substantial amount of work that they have. Take your pictures while you can, guys.
Oh, I'm done, yeah. I'm not in favor of you.
Background. The background.
At the big building?
Yep, definitely, yes. I'll make sure. Good shot. Yep.
Babe, come over here.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
All right. You guys good for me? Are you guys still taking pictures?
Yes, please.
All right, talk to me.
Oh, you don't want to take pictures?
And then this goes in and out.
Oh, okay.
So, am I going to take a picture or just a video?
Just a little in and out.
Alright, you guys enjoying the sun?
Oh yeah.
Alright, Skips.
Gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous.
There you go. Thank you much.
No problem, man.
Appreciate it.
No problem. Okay, guys,
did you need to take a picture
of the before we head out?
Sure. You got some stuff?
Yeah. Yeah, so that and that. I haven't gotten a shot of the big one.
That is gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous.
Hard to see.
Greenland. That's in Bird Nest of Greenland. Guys, welcome to Xunantunich. The word Xunantunich was derived, a Yucatecan word, Yucatecan. Yucatecan was actually a group of Mayans, which we still have them existing in the country of Belize today. Yucatecans, Mopan, and the Quechua Mayans, three group of Mayans, still living in Belize. So the word Xunantunich, like I said, means stone lady or maiden of the rock. Okay, maiden of the rock. The story was established, you know, many years ago, pretty much in the late 1800s, when a hunter, you know, ended up in this site here, who claimed that he saw a beautiful Mayan lady standing in front of the main temple to the back, okay, a structure to the back, a castillo. The lady was standing motionless. Frightened as he was, he ran to the village and informed the villagers as well as the priest. So they came back, in which he was accompanied by the high priest as well as some couple people to come and witness this beautiful motionless lady that he was talking about. So when arriving at this site here, there was no sign of any lady. So whether the guy had too much sugar in his tea that morning, we don't know. But that was the story given to us. Mm-hmm. Guys, they believe that the lady might have turned herself into the stone. We don't know. Okay, we don't know. But that's what they believe. The lady might have turned herself into the stone. The site was also established around 400 BC, 400 before Christ. That's when the site here was established, around 400 before Christ. The terminal classic was pretty much around 700 AD. 700 to 800 AD, that's the terminal classic of this area here. Terminal classic means the peak of its prosperity, okay? And also the collapse of this site was pretty much around 1000 AD. So pretty much around 700 to 800 AD was basically the beginning of the end. Beginning of the end. That's when most of these structures were erected. Okay? That was when Xunantunich was at his heyday, economically thriving. He was thriving. So therefore, they were able to erect these massive structures with the condition that they were going to be one of the most powerful people in this area here. But what happened? What actually led to the sudden collapse still remains a mystery. Still remains a mystery to us. It's just mere skepticism. Whether it was caused by diseases, we don't know. Tension, we don't know. Whether it was caused by the peasants losing a faith in the high priest, we don't know. Because imagine here you are being so obedient to the gods, would have been the elites, the high priests, because remember that they were the direct descendants of the gods. Okay? So talking to them was like talking to the gods. So imagine here you are being faithful with your offerings and your tithings. And when it's time for you to call upon rain, when you need rain to plant another set of crop, there is no rain. What do you do? What do you do? Doubts start to, you know, trickle into the society. So that could have probably caused uprise. We don't know. It could have been one of the factors that the archaeologists were putting more into consideration was the over-extraction of natural resources, the over-usage of natural resources. To erect a massive town like this, or city like this, guys, requires substantial amount of labor, but most of all, requires a lot of natural resources. And I'm talking about tapping into the forest. Mm-hmm. That was the reason why I actually showed you guys, you know, a lot of firewood along the highway. why they were making the white line. There was a reason why I showed you that. You notice a substantial amount of firewood that they're going to be using? Just a couple bags of white line. Because in order for you to get the white lime, which is the mortar, you have to cook the limestones. You have to heat the limestone so you can get the powder. We don't use dynamite. We use the heating. That's the mechanism that we use. Heating. They use dry wood. But hey guys, for them, they are actually meeting a demand for a short period of time. But unlike this was their life. This was for years and years and years to come. So instead of getting the dry sticks, picking up the dry sticks from the wood to burn the limestone, you had to cut the green ones. Mm-hmm. It was a slow heating process. So it's not like sending your kids to the back and go and pick up, you know, a couple, you know, dry sticks so that we can cook some white lime so that we can build our buildings. No. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about bringing down the forest, bringing it down to get firewood so that you can burn the limestone so you can get substantial amount of mortar, a hill of mortars, mm-hmm. to erect these structures. I'm okay. I don't want to confuse you guys. Mortar was used to actually stick the stone on top of each other. There is a record of a quarry where they actually cut stones. Okay? That's pretty much close to the parking lot. Okay. So the mortar was used to, you guys get me? Mm-hmm. To erect the stone on top of each other. Mm-hmm. We were also able to use snail shell to pulverize it, to kind of add nutrients, you know, to the mortar. So imagine erecting a structure like this. So imagine the amount of firewood that you need to cut, the amount of forest that you have to cut to erect these structures. And remember, we are only looking at one plaza here. What we're going to be doing is Plaza A. From here, you see the last structure to the back there, mm-hmm. which is considered as the one of the royal palace, which is also, this is where the artisans would have been living. This is where the astrologers would have been living, the overseers. This is their structure. Okay? This is where the diplomats would have been living. While the presidents would have been living in the White House all the way back there with his family. Okay? So we are only looking at Plaza A right here. We're not talking about Plaza B. Plaza B is far to the back, hidden under the forest. It has not yet been touched. Not yet been touched. I'm talking about series of rooms to the back. Wow. Structures to the back. Not touched. I'm talking about Plaza C, behind the El Castillo, the main building back there, untouched. So we're only talking about just a minute percentage of, you know, a tour of the structure visible, and yet to be able to comprehend or to imagine the amount of material being used to erect these structures right here in front of us. Not only that, these guys have to eat. You have to clear the forest for farming. That was the only way. They weren't able to go behind a computer and, you know, try to make an income for themselves. They had to touch the forest once more. So you had to cut it so you can plant your corn, plant your beans. That's what you had to do. But that's what they had to do. And you must understand that the system of farming that the Mayans used, which was also known as the Milpa system, was a short-term based farming, slash and burn. You cut the forest, you burn it, provide nutrients for a short period of time. And after that, the soil lose its fertility. And that's one of the reasons why history tells us that Mayans were nomadic people. Nomadic means that they moved from one place to another in search of fertile land. Okay? So they weren't able to live in a place for a long period of time, for a long period of time. They had to move because of, you know, so with the overextraction of the forest, that could have actually led to some climatic change which could have maybe fuel drop. Rain not coming in time. Mm-hmm. Maybe that could have been a factor that led to the collapse of this civilization here. Again, we don't want anybody to misinterpret collapse with extinction, because perceiving it as extinction will be stepping on Emiliano's toes. You notice what we are having buried under here? Mm-hmm. Valuable structures. Would they believe that this would have been a part of the observatory? Observatory, where we actually study astronomy. Mm-hmm. That's what they actually believe. This is what they actually tell us.
Such a structure would have been used to erect buildings. Hear it? The acoustics.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm. This way, guys.
This way.
Before the abandonment of this area here, guys, this way, before this area here was abandoned, there were a group of families. Actually, we were here about 2 months ago with the archaeologist, you know, the archaeologist in Belize, the only archaeologist so far, well-known archaeologist in Belize, Dr. Jaime Owen. We were so surprised that every day for 6 years I've been walking, trampling over this structure, these stones right here. He was the one who actually told us that there were a group of families who never wanted to abandon this place here. They wanted to cling on to what they had left. So what they did, they were able to collect some stones from this structure, and they were trying to create a barricade. They were trying to barricade and try to secure this structure here. So they were trying to inhabit this area here. And sacrifices were done in this area here. Sacrifices, you know, children were sacrificed as a result. It was similar to what actually took place at Kahal Pech, where you know that you were doing something illegal, so in order for you to please the gods, you had to offer a sacrifice. The children were sacrificed in the process of trying to steal, trying to compromise, trying to please, you know, or trying to have their gods compromise, you know, with your wrongdoing. Mm-hmm. Okay? Altar. That's what they actually did sacrifice right here. This would have been used to do sacrifices, stones, round stones, considered as altar, which would have been used for sacrificial purposes. Stealing would have been used to record special events that took place. We would have been looking at calendrical events that took place here. Okay? And we would have maybe seen the figure of the ruler, you know, who once ruled this area here, giving us all the information, hieroglyphic information, about what transpired, you know, or what he was doing, you know, or what kind of story, you know, he had at that time. But again, time has taken its toll on this stela. So they were able to collect some of the stela, the sort of stela that, or the stela that we'll be seeing in the bigger building back there, were collected from this particular area here. Okay? Guys, El Castillo, or the castle. 13 doorways, 13 story buildings, 13 chambers. Why number 13? There was a reason why I showed you guys the cyber tree, or the cotton tree, or the kapok tree. The Mayans believe that there is 13 layers of heavens, and they believe that the cotton tree, okay, or the kapok tree, or the cyber tree, was the one that holds the 13 layers of heaven. The tree is so huge. We don't have, they're not really large now, comparing to, you know, earlier. Most of our forest is secondary. So they believe that such a massive tree were the one that holds up the 13 layers of heavens. And that the root structure connects to the 9 layers of the underworld. And the cave being the entrance to that underworld, or the world of the dead, okay, or the evil god, or the 9 evil gods, okay? Guys, a structure Like this took about 300 years to be built. From 350 to about 550 AD. That's when this structure here was actually built. But we are looking at also a structure that was built ring above rings, layers above layers. It's like an onion right here. You build, you cover, you build, you cover every generation. 52 years. Build, cover. Okay? And the archaeologist tells us that they believe that this building here actually went about 20 feet higher than where it is right now. But again, nature has taken its toll, it collapsed. So 20 feet actually was collapsed. We lost it already. What do you guys notice about the stairs? Anybody?
Pretty.
What's up?
Pretty steep.
Pretty large.
Yeah. Well, Mayans really big.
Mayans were tall.
They look small, man.
the moon mean symbolizes fertility. Moon. Usually around moon, around the full moon, you guys know what I'm talking about. Life usually spring out.
Mm-hmm.
Life usually spring out. That's what symbolizes moon. When I first had my first baby, you know, one of the questions that the doctor asked me, when is going to be the full moon? I said, full moon, what the full moon got to do with my baby? The moon is up there, my baby is here. But somehow she told me something have kind of coexists.
Yeah, more babies with the are birth, born on a full moon.
You know, giving birth. Something like that. That's what she told me. That's my first time hearing that. Never heard of that. Maybe you guys never heard of it before
I've
as
heard
well.
That before. I've heard yeah. that. People yeah. have babies on
around
full
the full moon.
Mm-hmm.
So again, so the Mayan understood or knew that the full moon has great significance. Planting, harvesting, moon. Moon. That's the reason why when you collect thatch roofs building, you know, collect the thatch roofs material, the you see these palms right there? You see all these palms? When you collect that, you have to collect it during the full moon. If you collect it when it's the moon, is that right? It's only gonna last you about 2 to 3 years. If you collect it during the full moon, guess what? This can last you over 13 years. You see the big difference?
Mm-hmm.
Moon. Yep. Try it out. You're ready, Kali. I might not call him. Yeah, call him. What's up? Talk to me.
These stones, you're saying they brought them down there?
Oh, yeah. Every single thing you see here. But these were newly cut stones. These were actually newly cut stones to restore.
Oh, okay.
But they brought
okay,
it here. But everything you see here were okay. brought by the Mayans up here.
Okay. Okay. But those were newly cut.
These were cut because we're trying to restore.
Okay. Okay. I got my clear.
Believe me, you have not seen anything as yet. This is nothing. Believe me. You'll be amazed. I'm stunned. Okay. You want me to zoom on you guys? Right?
Yeah.
You want all of it, huh?
Get one zoomed and one not.
But would you be able to zoom when you get back home to get a better view of yourself?
Just do one far away and then zoom one.
All right, that's good right there. Let me get another one.
Sure.
Yep.
You want to put that away?
No problem, ma'am. The other
there you go. I was just trying to take a picture for you guys.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks,
Golden.
Oh, wait, is that one right there?
Guys,
oh,
take the pictures while you can. It's not every time that you come here, you get to see these monkeys as close as possible, like what you're seeing right here.
See the prehensile tail monkeys? Yeah. The black howler. Black collar monkeys.
Oh, there's a baby
right there. Where's the baby? Oh, yeah, yeah. Look at the baby right here. You see the baby? Right here. Oh, look before. Right in front of you. Yep.
Oh, right up there.
Yeah. Oh, see, yeah.
Yeah, he really is.
He's so small he is.
People always say,
can we take some pictures of him?
I'm gonna
sure.
Where's the camera?
Right here.
Look, he's young.
Oh, yeah.
Aww.
Aw, look at the little baby. Aw. Smile, baby monkey.
Last week I was here. I was hoping to be able to see them. By the time I come back, they were far gone. So it's an honor for me to be able to see them so close today.
Yeah.
So close to the lens.
That's awesome.
I want to hear them howl.
Pretty noisy.
I bet
crazy. Second loudest animal in the world, mama in the world.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
It's beyond second to my dog.
Over about, you can hear them over two, over a mile or two. Wow. When they're actually howling.
They eat the leaves?
Oh, yeah, they're feeding on leaves and they feed on leaves and fruits. These are vegetarians.
Oh, he is so tiny.
Take a picture of the small one, guys. Come on now. Come on now.
Yeah.
Take a picture of the small one now. Come on.
Oh, I'm getting it all in video, dude. So cute.
That's a male. It's a male baby.
Oh, there's a third one back there.
Yep.
Another
boy, he looks like a pretty healthy baby, doesn't he?
You're looking at a troop.
Oh,
troop, okay.
Yeah, there's another one up there. They're coming down. Whoa, we got some action here.
Get a picture than this, guys. Come on, take your pictures. Kodak moment. Kodak moment, guys.
Whoa, look at him go. Dang.
Awesome.
Wow. He knows his way around the street.
Is that a mating call?
More of a territorial call. But I can't do it. Every time I try to do it, I cough. So, unfortunately, if I have the night quill, I would be able to do it. We don't have the day quill nor the night quill.
Just careful,
bro.
You need the stout.
You got Rolling Stone, gather no mask, but I don't know about humans.
That baby is tiny. Tiny, tiny, tiny.
What is the difference between the mama and the baby? I notice everybody is very adoring the baby. How about the mama? I know mama feels jealous right now. Mama feels jealous right now.
Incredible. Absolutely incredible.
I believe this is the alpha male. Guys, you can't get anything better than this. Come on, take a picture, man. Come on. Kodak moments.
Kodak take moments. Your picture.
Please take a picture. Please take a good picture.
I'm making a movie over here.
Steve.
He's made a movie?
Yeah. Oh, man, look at him chewing as if he's eating lettuce. Look at him. Oh, yeah. That's what I'm talking about. He thinks he's trying. He can finish all this tree, you know. Look at him eating.
This is so cute.
I believe this is the alpha male right here, guys.
Oh, he's on display.
Let me see. Let me look at his face. Let me look at his chin.
Oh, awesome. Tell him to move his leaves. Speaking howler.
Oh, man. Yep. I think the two bullets indicated.
I can figure that out.
Come on, guys. I'm talking about his hand. He has two hands, right?
Right.
Oh, man. That's the synonymous word for hand. Bullets. Look like an alpha male to me here. I'm looking at another one there. I'm not sure if this is a juvenile male or a female, another female. I think that's another female right there.
This is the
alpha male right here.
That's so cool.
This is the alpha male right here, guys. Look at him hanging on his tail, peeing on his tail.
Three.
Oh, yeah. Look at him, man.
Oh, here comes this.
He's like, check out my tail skills, fool. One tail.
Okay, ready? You want to continue?
Why don't we go this way, guys?
So awesome. I know you guys are enjoying
your
monkeys.
That other little one came down over here.
Oh, the baby is so cute.
I know. That's his big brother or sister up there.
He's going to be that big one day.
Mm-hmm. All right.
They are serious about lunch over here.
Oh, yeah. They don't even acknowledge it.
He's actually behaving as if the tsunami is coming. He's eating his last supplies.
They probably consider this their temple.
time ago and I'll give you $100 to tell. I said it's okay, I'll pick up matters myself. Yeah, exactly. And that's what I prefer. You see, I want to stay here. The wall is cooler and the bridge broke, you know. I like the cool side. Again, don't tell anybody, guys. Don't tell anybody that I'm scared of heights. Like I said, I promise you guys, please, if you don't tell.
I'll take that promise.
All right, bro. So immediately after you guys are finished taking your... Enjoying this?
Sick shot right there, go.
Awesome. Don't want to get any further.
Don't worry, I have your back. I have your back, don't worry. As far as he can try, don't worry. I'm trying to make it in building in time. Trying to make it in exactly. That's what I'm talking about right there. Just trying to get some building right there behind.
Thank you.
I'll just check it out. Let me out. Maybe it might be a little bit cool, but this you guys are a distance, man.
So if you were a priest, you would be up here. If you were a mind priest,
the highest,
the highest, the elite. Yeah,
exactly, the guy, you know, the exclusive.
Virtually a descendant of a god.
Like I said, it would be like a pope hanging in the sea right here.
And your sacrifice would be right down there.
Yeah, they actually had the stuff right here at the top of here as well. Remember where the monkeys were?
Yeah.
There were those are rooms.
Yeah.
Right there, where we were actually walking. Actually, Dr. Jaime Awe is running to the innovation pretty soon.
Yeah.
And this right here, yes.
So this right here actually goes higher.
This would actually go higher. You're probably looking at maybe a solid rock.
Wow.
Okay, guys, what we want to do now, we want to go and play ball.
All right.
Okay. Glory, did you want to get a shot from here?
Oh, I did.
With us in it?
Oh, sure.
Don't get too close to the edge, guys. Alright, yep, go right ahead, bro.
You want to take it with that?
Yeah, over here.
In front of the camera.
Yep, don't go too close.
Yeah,
we don't want to end up like we don't want to end up like these guys back in Tikal. They were actually...
Yeah,
apparently there was a guy who was doing the same thing. He apparently, he actually slipped right off. You know, he was trying to get himself positioned for a camera picture and tumble right down, and that was the end of the picture right there.
Oh, goodness, wow. That's not us.
If you watch Discovery, you will notice the last picture, the last video. Anybody watch that before, the series? The last picture? I think there was a guy who was documenting some about bears in the wild, and he got...
So what do you think of the rune up here?
Last tape incredible. Or something like that?
Yeah, kind of is.
Yeah, but watch him. Come on, it comes from the U.S. Oh man, don't tell you guys are giving me an impression that I'm a TV fanatic. I'm not a television fanatic, guys.
Are
I only
you sure?
Watch, I only watch Tom and Jerry and Pink Panther now and again. Oh man, come on.
You only watch TV at Kaba Kassan's?
Kaba Kassan, what's that?
King Cassava's, yeah.
King Cassava, man. Oh, King Cassava. I used to. But after having kids, you gotta buy your own television now.
Yeah.
So when you never had any kids, you can go and sit down behind the, you know, King Cassava.
Do they like to play Nintendo?
What's that?
They play Nintendo?
Me? No, I don't have my kids play Nintendo.
No.
It's more of a more social than to stick behind. I don't encourage them to play with those type of stuff.
How many kids do they?
I only have two. I almost giving you the impression that I have nine, huh? Don't worry, no. Two, and that's about it, guys. Guys, at that time, they never had any Tempur-Pedic. Neither did they have any sleep number bed. So they only use straw mats. So all we are looking at here is just a series of rooms, guys. Series of rooms. Is a Gloria down there?
Yeah.
Very good. You guys can go. You can go down there directly to the building, but you gotta be very careful as you go down. Let me actually have Gloria.